Hey guys and girls, welcome back to the walkthrough. We're now on part 25 and we're going to start the boss level Jacques, which I'm a massive fan of. I managed to get the title right there. The sky looks dark and threatening, but actually it's a brilliant level. And for one thing, one of the reasons why I love it so much is because it's my favourite bit of music, so if I could turn up, I would. I can't find a controller, annoyingly. Enemies here are quite nightmarish, although they're quite monster-like, but then they've got flowers as well, which is a bit weird. I think it's meant to be a nightmare, basically. And there's lots of falls here which you can blame to get platforms to rise and all that. It's quite cool in that respect. First of all, we shall go this way for some reason. But first of all, let's get this stuff up here. Let's go quickly. Don't worry, we'll be coming back along to here. Don't worry about that. I feel like I should stop commentating and just like look through the music. But believe me, just search up Jacques Spyro 1 soundtrack. It's incredible. Listen to it, that's so funky and oh my god, it's so good. In fact, there's a thing called a Stuart Copeland anthology in which he's chosen like his best work outside the police. And this track's actually in it. That's how amazing it is. And I can't believe there's gems, damn it. Yeah, it's in the anthology. It's called Rain, I believe, in that. I still call it Jacques because that's the level that it's from. That's what it was associated with. Get these guys now. The reason why I went and got their stuff back there first will be explained a bit shortly. We'll get these guys first up there. The music will be a bit glitchy as well in this game, so I'd advise you to download or like. I think the soundtrack's available for free online if you go on to Galabadia Hotel, something like that. Oh my god, a guy with a flower actually just trying to hurt me and succeeded. So good. I actually learned this on guitar. That's how much I love this song. I actually went on guitar and thought, yeah, I'm gonna learn this bad boy. It deserves to be learned. So we've got some stuff up here. Now I want to make our way back round because we'll get to that a bit later on. Down there, where that bit there is, that little corridor there, is where the boss is. There's still a lot to do first. So if we go back along here to the very start here, where this guy is. Get him. Get him. Damn it! You have to get to that tower there, because that tower took me forever to figure out that one. It's quite hard actually, not higher than you think it will be. Let's go back to normal again. This one now. No way, Jose! Oh, that was close. Damn it. Bad luck there. So I got this dragon and I thought, yeah, it's definitely taking me ages to get to this dragon. I was really excited. And what does he say?
Thank you for releasing me.
Seriously, I was like, really? Give us something better than that, you know. So, yeah, this is the only boss level as well, but there's only two dragons. And, oh my god, my controller. Dear, oh dear. Forget, of course, that it is a PS3 game, of course, this one. And the controller connected. There we go. I'm okay now. For some reason, the analog stick stopped working. That's annoying. I have to do the analog stick thing. I can't really stop recording and start again, you know, a bit much. Okay, this is going to be interesting, though. Oh. Okay, that's a bit weird, because I really don't use the directional pad, D-pad, rather, that often. This is a bit weird. So, I'll make it a bit for now. Ugh, damn it. This is really weird. Okay, along here now, up to here. I'm only thinking, I was going to record two parts, I might actually only record one now, I'm not sure. Anyway, so this is like a weird pedestal thing, sort of like that like in Lofty Castle. It's really hard to get that last one correctly. You have to really sort of follow it around to get the enemies, as I showed you there. Well, showed you how not to do, I should say. Try again. Oh, come on! That was a very clear. I was definitely in his path there. Oh, honestly. And I now know that we're 4 minutes in at least now because. There we go. Because I know that the soundtrack rather, is it's 4 minutes in length completely. That is it. That's how much of a nerd I am for this level. Come on, see if full. It'd be a lot easier if it wasn't on the D-pad. Oh, good lord. I've also, like, you know, primitive on the D-pad. I never liked first using the analogs, I can find that weird, and now this is the weird thing now, which is crazy. Hey, I just met you, this is crazy. I'm in the valley. Whoa. Anyway, Yeah, this is a nice bit of floor here that you get when you get on that huge tower. It takes a few times to get it right, as I showed you there. And that was without the D-pad. Imagine me trying that without analog sticks, rather. That'd be crazy. Nice long glide. We had to use... I mean, the dragons don't lie here. You have to use top of your jump here. There we go, let's get these platforms. And this business background is up there. Up there is where the corridor is, so it sort of all loops round in the end. Oh no way, Jose! Bye! Spyro fell. Spyro blunder, as one walkthrough would say. But enough about that. Anyway, let's try again. This is really weird about analog stick. I don't like it. It's really, really, really weird. There we go. That's where we want to get up to. Over around here, there's a nice little bit here with the two gems and a nice key. And that's a good key. I really hope I've got the gems though, because the last bit of the level goes on right to the very end. It goes on for like an epic boss fight sort of area at the end. And like, I don't really fancy coming back from the epic boss fight to find the last couple of gems. So, better we'll be here. Oh yeah. It's quite angry for some reason. Why? Okay, so right here, let's go for that. Have that. And then we'll just get ourselves up here now. Maybe we get the last bit, the last assault, as it were. Oh, for God's sake! This is really not my day. Yeah, here we go. Actually, it's a good experience for me, I think, actually, just learning to live without the usual methods of control. Down here now. Can't slow you down because we missed the gems otherwise. To the boss. Although the boss, it's still quite simple to be honest with you. An awesome boss though, nonetheless. Less.
Any advice before this battle?
Advice? A wise dragon once told me, aim high in life, but watch out for flying boxes.
Huh?
That's a pretty good advice. That's been my motto in life from now on, I think, to be honest. Okay, here we go! So you avoid the boxes, but then flame him. We'll just keep following him, and he will move back. Slowly but surely. I'm pretty certain what the gems will need to as well now. He might stop and throw some boxes at you, but most of the time, he'll just wait for you. Come on, here we go. Across the platoon. Last few gems up there. There we go. It's more of a it's a chase, but it's not the most difficult of things. Oh yes, it should be three up here now. Yes! At someone about 500 gems, two dragons. I managed it even without log sticks, most of it. So there we go. Jacques. Okay, so I'm used to doing Jacques. It's my favourite boss level. Jacques, I should say. I thought it was my name, so it sort of makes sense. And here we go. We've got all the gems, of course, we get in the world. But beware, Spyro. Nasty as well, not the most friendly place you will find. I'm not surprised, it's a junkyard after all of all sorts of creatures. But it's not too bad, to be honest with you. Although I was expecting, you know, something big, bold and terrifying as I was to enter Nasty's world. So we get here, I'm like, come on, I finally got here, this is it, Nasty's world. Or Nasty, rather. And this is it, this is the home world. Just this round bit here. He's quite lazy, isn't he? He wasn't really thinking, I'll just fire a grand entrance. Good old Nasty Knock. Tell you what, I'll do this bit here in this part, I might as well, to be honest with you. I mean, there's not much to do here. Let's get all the dragons. Most of the gems, some of the gems are inside that dragon's mouth, and that one's mouth, I think, as well, actually. So we can't get everything here, first of all. It's called Nork Nexus, this place here. I only got 200 gems, because, of course, it is quite a small area. And there's the last Lunis, he doesn't want much, you know, because of course, you're here, this is it. So let's talk to the first dragon. And this is really weird, because this is where old dragons come back.
Hey, didn't I already free you?
You're in Nasty's world now, Spyro, and you are the dragon who must defeat him.
Bring him on, I'm ready!
Reach the exit in each of Nasty's lands, then you can challenge the Nork himself.
Interesting, eh? Oh, what I will say is, though, it's crazy that dragons actually came here, and then they get trapped again. That's what it seems to be anyway. They went here to try and take on Natin, or got themselves trapped with Crystal again. How silly, eh? And also, the dragons' voices, half of them all changed. It's like, I'm sure it was not much effort to get the same voice actors. Like, I mean, his voice was quite deep and dark, and now it's quite comforting almost, and lighter. I don't know. It's a small criticism. But anyway, the next part, which I do, the first proper level of, what's it called? Of Natty's World, which is Nort Cove. See you then.